Jackie Robinson made his MLB debut in 1947 with the Brooklyn Dodgers. He is recognized as the first black player in modern-day baseball. However, Robinson was not the first overall black man in MLB. It was William Edward White. He was biracial and passed as a white man. He was born on October 1860 in Miller, Georgia. He was the son of plantation owner Andrew Jackson White and slave Hannah. He played a single game with the Providence Grays in 1879 as a first baseman. He was the only former slave to play in MLB. The first openly black player in MLB was Moses Fleetwood Walker. Unlike White, Fleet Walker did not pass as a white man. He was victim of racial prejudice. He was born on October 7, 1856 in Mount Pleasant, Ohio. As a catcher, he played 42 games for the Toledo Blue Stockings in 1884. He was the best catcher I ever worked with, but I disliked a Negro and whenever I had to pitch to him I used to pitch anything I wanted without looking at his signals. One day he signaled me for a curve and I shot a fastball at him. He said, "I'll catch you without signals, but I won't catch you if you are going to cross me when I give you signals." And all the rest of that season he caught me and caught anything I pitched without knowing what was coming. He was followed by his brother and teammate Weldy Walker. Weldy played 5 games for the Blue Stockings during the same period. There were no black players after the 1884 season. The reason is because of star player Cap Anson of the Chicago White Stockings. Anson was against the idea of playing in the same ballpark than a black baseball. Due to Anson's refusal to play against Walker, the 1883 exhibition game between the Chicago White Stockings and the Toledo Blue Stockings almost been canceled. Anson later relented and Walker was allowed to play. Chicago won the game 7-6. Anson faced backlash from at least one Toledo newspaper. It was called the Toledo Daily Blade. The Blade was not only supportive of Walker, but also claimed that the city and the team also supported Walker. Unfortunately, Anson's action led many players and managers to follow his lead. In 1887, the New York Giants, a MLB team, wanted to acquire Walker and pitcher George Stovey from the Newark Little Giants, a Eastern League team. Stovey was also a black man. However, Anson still publicly refused to take the field against black players. As a result, black players were barred from MLB. Bill White died on March 29, 1937 in Chicago, Illinois. He was 76. Fleet Walker died on May 11, 1924 in Cleveland, Ohio. He was 67. His brother, Weldy, died on November 23, 1937 in Steubenville, Ohio at 77.